الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين، أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد، طب القلوب ودوائها وعافية الأبدان وشفائها ونور الأبصار وضيائها، وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم. اللهم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. So in the previous reminder, I mentioned the effects of wudu. So wudu ablution has a physical effect on the body as well as having a spiritual effect on the body. And I mentioned one hadith, and there's many other hadith which are similar to the hadith which I mentioned in regards to when a person does wudu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala omits and erases, due to that wudu, him performing that wudu, sins of his body. So the organs that we wash in wudu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes away those sins from those organs. And at the end of the wudu, from the hadith of Sayyidina Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala, we understood that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam told the companions alayhim ridwan that the person comes out from performing wudu in a state that he is naqi, he is totally clean and pure. But again, some of us may think to ourselves that look at this virtue which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to us, a blessing which Allah has given to us from just doing wudu. We do istighfar and tawbah all the time, but we neglect this point. We've forgotten that even though we do istighfar and tawbah, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala physically has told us as well that look, by performing your wudu on the tongue of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we've learned by you doing wudu, what happens? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala erases your sins. So subhanAllah, this is the sharf that Allah has given to the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. But then again, sometimes we think to ourselves after committing sin, and even though we may think to ourselves that look, we do wudu, Allah is going to omit and take away these sins through the blessings of doing this wudu, we receive this from the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But only if I had not committed a certain sin, only if I could be totally pure like the way I was born. Subhanallah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned to the companions alayhim ridwan that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put such effect in that wudu that when a person sincerely does wudu to purify himself, to gain closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and establish prayer, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that that individual will be such is as if his mother has just given him birth. So he will be in the state, same sort of state. So he will be pure like the way a baby would be pure, meaning clean from sin, clean from anything which is of dirt and filth of the dunya and sin. So he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that أَيُّمَا رَجُلٍ قَامَ إِلَى وُضُوءِهِ يُرِيدُ الصَّلَاةَ, that whichever man stands to perform wudu and he has the intention of establishing prayer from that. ثُمَّ غَسَلَ كَفَّيْهِ نَزَلَتْ كُلُّ خَطِيَّةٍ مِنْ كَفَّيْهِ مَعَ أَوَّلِ قَطْرَةٍ مِنَ الْمَاءِ, that when he washes his hands, you know, from the beginning drop of water that touches his hands, the sins of his hand begin to fall. Yeah, meaning that they begin to fall. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then says, فَإِذَا مَضْمَدَ وَاسْتَنْشَقَ وَاسْتَنْثَرَ نَزَلَتْ كُلُّ خَطِيَّةٍ مِنْ لِسَانِهِ وَشَفَتَيْهِ مَعَ أَوَّلِ قَطْرَةٍ. Subhanallah, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, when he places water in his nose, he places water into his mouth, and he gargles his mouth, the sins of his tongue, his mouth, his lips, all of these sins fall off from his body. This is the blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to the ummah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam through this wudu. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then says that when a person washes his face, all of the sins of his face fall from his hearing and from his seeing, his vision, from the beginning drop of water. So meaning everything, yeah? So the nose, like I previously mentioned, we sniff things, we smell haram, we see haram. When a person washes his face, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala omits and takes away these sins in a form that they fall off his body, to an extent that when he washes his hands, including his elbows, washes his feet, including his ankles, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes him pure, safe and sound in such a way from every sin is as if his mother has just given him birth. So subhanAllah, this is the blessing that Allah has given to us. So day in, day out, we always are striving to do tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what tawbah means. Yet you turn from sin, migrate from sin and come to haqq, come to the truth, come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah has given us within this a very simple process that can benefit us and give us a boost in attaining that forgiveness from sins. And that in a way is our wudu. So before we even make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we do wudu, many of our sins have fallen off. And we actually may be standing in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, supplicating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a way that maybe we don't have a sin. Because the wudu and the salah that we just read has erased all of those sins. Who knows, this is possible. Why? Because we find from the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that our sins fall. But this is like the spiritual side of understanding what benefit it gives to us spiritually. What physical effect does it give to us? So, you know, many of us always, you know, decorate, embellish ourselves, you know, beautify ourselves with different sort of things, fragrances, makeup, you know, jewelry. We wear fancy watches, fancy clothes and garments and everything. So we stand out. It looks like you're an individual of value, of qadr. People should respect you and know that you're not someone who is, you know, off the road, someone who is poor, who doesn't have anything. Everyone wants to show their value. They want to show that I'm an individual who has value. I'm an individual who should be respected. These are things that you find within a human being, within the nature of a human being. No one would want to be disrespected or disregarded. Now, this wudu gives you sharaf and honor in that way. Now, how is this wudu going to give you sharaf and honor in that way? Sayyidina Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala an says that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Inna ummati yud'auna yawm al-qiyamati ghurran muhajjalina min athar al-wudu. Faman istata'a minkum an yatila ghurratahu falyaf'al." Meaning that my ummah on the day of judgment will be called in a state that they would be ghurran muhajjalin min athar al-wudu, from the effects of wudu. Ghurran muhajjalin, what does this mean now? Ghurran muhajjalin, the word ghurran muhajjal, it comes from the horse. The ghur, yeah, means a, you can say it's a unique marking, but this marking is the whiteness or the white stripe that you'd find going through a horse's head. So you know, like you find a black horse and he has a unique white stripe going through the head, this would refer to as the ghurra for it. And the same with muhajjaleen. What does muhajjaleen mean? Muhajjaleen means the paws, yeah, the legs, meaning the bottom parts of the horse, these being white, because these are ray markings that would always stand out. Ray markings that would always stand out. And many people who buy horses and buy animals or do trading and business in animals, they'll find that the more of a ray marking the animal has, the more it costs. Yeah, that puts value to it because it's something which makes the animal look much more beautiful. It makes the animal stand out. So on the day of judgment, when the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam will be called, we will be like ghurril muhajjalin. Yeah, our faces will be illuminated. Yeah, with the noor because of wudu. Our hands and our feet will be illuminating with noor. Why? Because of the athar and the effect of wudu. This is how you're going to be recognized on the day of judgment. People will know this is the ummati of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the value and the qadr that Allah has given to us. How we will be respected and known on the day of judgment because we're the ummatis of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now this is very important for us to understand. And like in narrations is mentioned as well, that the companions alayhim ridwan asked the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, "Kayfa ta'rifu man lam ya'ti ba'du min ummatika ya Rasulullah?" That how will you recognize those people from your ummah who will come later, O Messenger of Allah, meaning that those who will be presented to you on your hawd. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said to them, "Da ara'ayta law anna rajulan lahu khayl ghurrun muhajjalatun bayna dhahri khaylin duhmin buhmin Aisudin ala ya'rifu khaylahu," meaning that if a man from amongst you had a horse which is ghurran muhajjalin, meaning he had these rare unique markings, yeah, and that horse was placed between black, dark, same colored horses, yeah, so black, dark horses, would the man be able to recognize his horse? Yes, so if your horse, which is ghurran muhajjalin, ghurran muhajjalatun, meaning that he has these rare markings, and you place it between, you know, all black horses, you recognize which one is your horse because of those unique markings. your unique mark. And so the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, would the man be able to recognize his horse? The companions alayhim ridwan say yes. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, فَإِنَّهُمْ يَأْتُونَ غُرًّا مُحَجَّلِينَ مِنَ الْوُضُوءِ. On the day of judgment, my ummah will be presented to me. They will come to me in the form that their body will be, let the ghurran muhajjaleen. Their face will be illuminated with nur, their hands and their feet, all of these parts will be illuminating from nur. Why? Because of wudu. وَأَنَا فَرَتُهُمَ عَلَى الْحَوْضِ. And I will be the one who will be welcoming them on my hawd. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who will be given the ability to present themselves in the presence of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the hawd. May Allah make us amongst those who will drink from the blessed palm, the blessed hand of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So the same way, Imam Ahmad narrates a hadith in which he says that a man said to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كيف تعرف أمتك يا رسول الله من بين الأمم فيما بين نوحي إلى أمتك. How will you, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, recognize your ummah? Because there's ummahs all the way from the time of Sayyidina Nuh alayhi wa sallam to your ummah. How will you recognize your ummah from amongst all of these ummah? The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, هم غرٌ محجلون من أثر الوضوء. That they will be with those rare illuminating markings on their body from the effects of wudu. This is how I will recognize them. So this means that this ummah has been given this unique blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through the asar and the effects of wudu, what does he do? He illuminates our face. And you'll see this, and this is something very clear as well, that I always say that, brothers who do wudu and everything, this is the best way of keeping yourself looking young, handsome, and the same with our sisters as well, because this is that nur that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives to you. There's no need for us to always, use those things which are substances and chemicals and everything to make ourselves look outstanding. No, Allah has given that unique thing to us. That's wudu. That's the greatest form of purifying. It says the greatest makeup also. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through the blessings of this, is going to make us amongst those who are going to hold value on the day of judgment. That when we come and we arise on the day of judgment and we presented amongst all of the nations, people will be able to recognize that, look, this is Ghurrun Muhajjaleen, he must be from the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Yeah, you will be prioritized, you'll be looked at, people will be valuing you. So even though in this dunya now no one may value us, it doesn't matter. What matters is what happens on that day, the day that we will be judged. Why? Because then everything will be exposed. So like the way, we like showing off about everything on our Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Grams and everything, we write everything that we've done. Yeah, we should sometimes think to ourselves that when our book of deed on the day of judgment is going to be open, is it going to say that this individual is the one who actually tried to follow this way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Or are we going to be amongst those who are exposing themselves to haram all the time, exposing and making themselves a fitna for other individuals? So wudu is a very important role which is connected to every form of worship that we do. And it's very important that we correct this wudu first. So there's lectures that have been given previously on wudu and seminars that had been taken in the masjid also. But here I just wanted to mention a few points that I'm sure that now every single one of us who understands, in a day, in a time like this and an age like this, where we're always just washing our hands and doing all of these things, that it wouldn't make a difference if you just put a slight more effort in and you actually perform the full wudu with the intention that you're doing this, why, to gain closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Washing your hands 20 seconds, just add another few seconds, a few minutes, and you can complete your whole wudu. And through the blessings of the wudu, you're omitting and erasing your sins. And indeed, every single one of us would like to be an individual who is pure and clean from sin. And the same way, the athar and the effect of the wudu is going to be such that it's going to put a stamp onto you. A stamp onto you that this is the ummati of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who used to do wudu. And this is how we will be recognized on the day of judgment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to always remain in the state of wudu as possible as we can. Yeah, to the best level of ability that we can, we always try and exert all of our efforts in always to remain in the state of wudu. And like I mentioned, that the Salaf Salihin and all mentioned that people who stay and remain in the state of wudu, it gives them a clear understanding, it saves them from sin as well. Why? Because they always will refrain from sin, thinking that I may break my wudu, or this will affect my wudu spiritually or physically. The same way, it makes a person cautious with touching certain things, refraining from certain things which may be haram or dirty. The same way just wudu puts blessings into the person's actions, his amal, when he does certain things, Allah places barakah into it, and he will fulfill those things, and there will be blessings in those things. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to act upon what we've heard, passing on to other brothers and sisters. Ameen, bijahin nabil, ameen.